One last one after this picture. The groom wants to say a couple of words, and then we're done with the microphone. He wants to start the party.
So I got bad news for you guys. It's going to be more than a couple words. But we paid for the extra 30 minutes at the end, so don't worry. We're going to make it up for it. So I'm going to need every single person, Tina, you're the one excluded person if you don't want to do it, to stand up right now. All right, I'm going to do a social experiment. For the next 10 seconds, I'm going to count down, put my hands up. I need you to make as much noise as you can. And I'm not talking about like I'm embarrassed to clap in front of people and I'm going to do it on my thigh. I'm talking about like my team just won the Super Bowl for the Canadian family, Stanley Cup, whatever y'all like. Are y'all ready? All right, let's do this. Ready? All right, let's do it. Come on. Let's go. Come on. Thank you so much. I've always wanted a standing ovation. I gotta be honest. It lives up to the hype. And now that my ego's needs are out of the way, I really want to talk about you guys, because you can sit down, by the way. A lot of people get really nervous to talk in front of people. But to me, it's an honor and a privilege to stand in front of all the people that mean the most to me and Tina in our lives and say thank you. See, if I was nervous, I'd probably picture you all naked. And I would have to walk up to my cousin and say, it ain't that cold in here, brother. But I'm not nervous. There are very few times in one's life where they get to stand in front of everyone that matters to them and tell them thank you. And while I can't name every single person in here, there are a few people I need to make sure I say thank you to. See, Tina is a love chameleon. And what that means is she has a huge heart and she lets love in. And when she lets love in, she starts to take on personalities of other people. So to Tina's friends, Tori, your chill and your humor, Kristen, your energy and your passion, Talia, the way you always show up for people, Ange, your humor, your heart, and frankly, some of you are crazy too. Julia, your heart and your hope, every single one of you have helped shape Tina into the woman that I love, and I thank you so much. It's a wonderful feeling to have an amazing friendship with my friends, but also you guys. And see, now a lot of you guys imagine the man that's standing up here, and it makes sense to you. Now my friends, Zane, my friends are like, who the hell is this if you looked at me 6 years ago? You know, I'll never forget, Ron once texted me and he said, bro, when I think about you, I think about growth, because you're just a different person. And it's because, though, a large part because of you guys, man. Like, Stefano, you've had my back for the last 4 years. We've been through the trenches, man. I'll always love you. Ron, you taught me the difference between real and fake and how to hold on to what's real. Quan, you taught me to find the joy in every single situation. I've never met anyone that laughs the way you do. And now Quan also taught me one other thing that I want to teach everyone right now. So we were in Las Vegas, right? And I'm doing my thing. And I know you guys are thinking, he's talking to girls, da, da, da. No, my thing is looking like an idiot. So Quan walks up to me and goes, bro, you look bad right now. I was like, what you mean? He's like, you have no rhythm. And I'm like, help me, bro. Help me, bro. So I want to teach you guys, for all the people that look like me and are worried that you might be dancing with people that look like Quan on the dance floor, what he taught me, all right? So watch this, right? I look like I have no rhythm. Watch when I hold my stomach. So if you're nervous about getting on the dance floor, hold your stomach and have a good time. Now, every friend group needs a hype man, and Ryan, you have always been that hype man, and you have gotten me through a lot of situations you don't even know about, but I appreciate you, brother. Scott, you taught me what it means to be family when you're someone's friend, because every single time you showed up, we didn't even know where you were for 15 minutes because you were checking on my parents and making sure that they were okay. Terrence, you, the mayor of Montclair, man. You have more friends than people are in this room, and it's crazy, but you taught me what it means to be a friend. And you taught me how to let love in and, you know, forgiveness. And I appreciate that. Now, Heeb, you taught me about the importance about being on time. Because you ain't never been on time before today. But frankly, you taught me what it's like to have a brother. And you taught me what it's like to love and care about someone, man, and I appreciate you so much. You really have become my family. Now, the Tina's family, all 4,595 of y'all. Tina's family has something called Cousins Fest, right? And it's kind of what it sounds like. Yeah, there it is. Tina's family has something called Cousins Fest where everyone gets together and it looks like a meeting in the United Nations, man, I'm not gonna lie. There are people there that are paler than me and they're like, I'm Tina's cousin. I'm like, what? But the love that is in that room is unlike anything I've ever experienced before, man, and the partying, the drinking, the conversations, everything else, man. I just wanna say that I'm so excited that the next Cousins Fest I get to come as an officially family member. And bring a little bit of Scottish to the family. And now, Christian, Tyler, and Brandon, every single one of you have welcomed me into the family like a brother. And I don't think you understand just how much that means to me. You know, about a year ago, I was sitting down with Brandon and Tina, and Brandon asked me, who are your top five lyricists of all time? And these are rappers. And for dad. And I go, you got to put Big L up there. And a lot of people are sitting here like, who's Big L? And that's the point. And Brandon looked at Tina and he goes, yeah, he I sis, he'll do. Dawn, you're the mother of the group, of the siblings, man. You somehow show up and take care of everybody, but you're also the life of the party and I love you forever. But make your own damn margaritas. To Ken and Tony, you should be so proud of the woman that sits right here and everything that you had to do with it. I don't even have words for it. Now, Erica, whoo! Erica's not just Tina's mom, she's Tina's best friend. And the best parts of Tina, I think she got from her mother. And I'll say this, there's not a person in here who's not better for having met Erica. And there's not a person in here who's not learned how to love and accept love. Because you've done it, man. You taught us all, Erica, and I love you and I appreciate it. Only two more groups, then we can go back to drinking and dancing, I promise. So, my family, all 12 of us, we ain't got the size, but we got the heart. Where's Emma? Right here. Emma, when I met Tina, I didn't just gain a wife, I gained a friend in you. I watched you grind and chase your passion, and I don't think you understand just how much it motivates me every single day. Dad, whew! Dad, there's things that frighten me about my future, but there are two things that don't. And one is being a husband, and the other is potentially being a father one day, and that's because I get to follow in your footsteps. You showed me every single day what it means to be a man, what it means to sacrifice, show up, and care about your family. And I love you forever. He tried to teach me humility, but I'm not really picking up on that one yet. Mama. When I wrote this, I started crying immediately. You know, I could make this whole 10-minute speech just about you and what you mean to me. But there are really two things I want to focus on. You taught me how to recognize an amazing woman. You taught me to recognize strength in a woman. It's not just about her looks, but it's who she is. And you ingrained that in me. And without you, I never would have met and recognized this beautiful woman. So thank you, mother. I also think I got my character from you. And now I read that K. character is an index of how you treat people who can't offer you anything and how you treat people who can't fight back. And I would say that is who you are to your core, and I love you forever for that. Tina, babe, wife, Miss Christ. Whoo, I like that. Okay. I got that, don't worry. Now, I stood up a few hours ago in front of all these people, and I promised to love you for the rest of my life. And now, while I know that'll bring challenges, I also know it's the easiest promise I've ever made in my life just because of how much I love you. Now, I haven't really told this story to other people, but here goes. When I met Tina, I was really struggling in life. I was in a very, very dark place. And the week before I met Tina, I was getting ready to leave my job in finance, and I walked into the United States Marine Corps, and I got enlistment paperwork. And I got home, and I stared at that paperwork, and I thought to myself, if I can't have purpose in life, maybe I could have purpose in death. And a week later, I walk into a burger joint, and here's this beautiful girl with a smile that lights up the room who gives me the time of day. And I didn't know it at the time what that feeling was, but it felt different. And I had to wait 2 weeks for you to text me back because you won the bet, but text me back you did. And every single day since then, you've texted me. I remember I met your friends, and I was like, I'm gonna marry Tina. And they were like, let's calm down. Julia said it a little bit nicer, but everyone else was like, let's calm down. But what they didn't understand at the time is that I didn't just love you, and you didn't just love me. You taught me how to love myself. You didn't save my life, you gave me life. You took that dark cloud that was over my head, and you pierced it with light, and you let the love of every single person in this room in. And I'm gonna spend the rest of my life saying thank you and letting you know just how happy I am to be your wife. Oh, to be your husband, whatever. It's 2022. If I want to be your wife, I will. So with that, I would like everyone to raise a glass to the people and the love in this room. Cheers.